Kia ora folks, today we take a look at a PTO stirrer and slurry tanker in action. First up, you'll need to connect the stirrer to one of your tractors and make your way to the pond. Once there, back the tractor up to the pond to achieve the best position. Now that you're set, select 540 on your PTO and lower the stirrer into the pond. Remember, if the pond has a crust, let the stirrer cut through it. Don't force it. Aim for a depth of around 1 meter below the surface for the best results. Stirring is generally recommended every time you're pumping, but with a slurry tanker, it can be less frequent. Moving on, bring your slurry tanker in for pumping. Lower the auto fill arm into the docking station, ensuring a tight seal, and engage the PTO. Make sure to check that you've got vacuum, and then it will take a few minutes to fill up. As it's filling, you will also see the level rising on the gauge. Once the tanker is full, turn off the PTO and lift the auto fill arm. The vacuum pump will automatically switch to pumping mode, ready for spreading into paddock. Now, as you prepare to spread, open the rear gate valve, switch on the PTO, and select a speed suitable for your conditions, avoiding ponding. Nevada's rain wave demonstrates the even, accurate, and drift-free spread of effluent. And there you have it, a straightforward solution for spreading effluent to your paddocks. If you'd like to hear more about our stirrer and tanker range, please give us a call.